Welcome to this class. In this class, we are going to solve some more problem based on construction of Fourier series for the function corresponding interval. The third problem is in the previous class we discussed already two problems. Third problem today, this class first problem along with the previous class is a third problem. Find the Fourier series expansion of f of x equals x into 1 minus x into 2 minus x in the interval x greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 2. Hence, deduce the sum of the series that 1 by 1 cube minus 1 by 3 cube plus 1 by 5 cube minus 1 by 7 cube, etc. They are not given right-hand side value. We have to find out what's the value of this series. That is deduce part. We have to do it later. You are already familiar with the deduce part in the previous class. First, we have to construct the Fourier series. What they are given in the problem? Given. Now, first you multiply the given function. What's the given actually? F of x equals x into 1 minus x into 2 minus x. First, suppose you multiply that. Now, we get cubic polynomial is in the form. You know how to multiply. First, you multiply these two. We get x 2 minus 2x minus x is 2 minus 3x minus into minus plus x square. 2 minus 3x plus x square multiplied by x. Finally, we get x square minus x cube. Finally, I have to multiply by what actually x. What we get x cube minus 3x square plus 2x. In the interval, over the interval, what they are given actually 0 to 2. X greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 2. Therefore, I have taken the open or closed interval 0, 2. Now, I want to construct the Fourier series. Observe carefully here. The given interval, what's the given interval is 0, 2. Therefore, it's referred to whenever the interval starts from 0, refer to which case? First case. What is first case? Our general interval is 0 to 2L. Now, equate upper limit of the given interval must be equal to upper limit of the first case of general interval is 2L. That implies what we get actually L is equal to 1. Once we get L, and then I have to find out N pi x by L. What is my N pi x by L is N pi x. First, we have to find out these values. Don't find out orally. Please find out, do it manually, and then I have to avoid the mistake because the role of L is very, very important in the construction of Fourier series. Then, Fourier series for f of x over 0, 2, over the interval 0, 2 is f of x equals a0 by 2 plus summation n ranging from 1 to infinity, because here we can't go for even or odd because the interval is belongs to which case? First case. Whatever type of function, don't worry about that. First, you observe the interval. An into cos of n pi x, and then bn summation n ranging from 1 to infinity, bn sine of n pi x. Okay. Now, what are the formulas for a naught, an, and bn? 1 by L. What is L is 1, 0 to 2, f of x dx, and then an, 1 by L is 1 by 1, 0 to 2, f of x into cos of n pi x with respect to x, and bn is what actually 1 by 1, 0 to 2, f of x sine of n pi x with respect to x. Okay. Now, next try to find out the values of a naught, an, and bn using the given function. You already expand the given function is what actually x cube minus 3x square plus 2x. Now, next try to find out the value of a naught. What is my a naught? Here's formula 1 by 1 is 0 to 2. What's the function polynomial in it's a polynomial of degree 3, x cube minus 3x square plus 2x with respect to x is nothing but x to the power of 4 by 4, and then we put a bracket for this minus 3 into what is the integration of x square with respect to x is x cube by 3 plus 2 into what is the integration of x is x square by 2. What's the limit? 0 to 2. Okay. Now, you don't apply upper limit, minus limit, lower limit. You go for term by term, apply upper limit. So, minus simultaneously go for lower limit. 1 by 4, while applying the limit, keep the constant outside 1 by 4. X to the power of 4. What is x to the power of 4? 2 to the power of 4. 2 to the power of 4. What are 2 to the power of 4 minus 0. 2 to the power of 4 minus 0. Yeah, just a minute. This is to write properly. For this, 2 to the power of 4 minus 0. While come to this, 3, 3 cancel, 2, 2 cancel. Now what we get actually, minus 2 cube minus 2 cube minus 0 plus 2 square minus 0. Yeah. Now I have to simplify. Then 2 power of 4 is 16 divided by 4 is what we get actually 4. Minus 2 cube is 8 plus 4. What we get finally? 0. Therefore, a naught is what actually? 0. A naught is 0. Next, I have to find out an and bn. What is my bn value? Bn is nothing but 1 by, bn is 1 by 0. 1 by 1 is 1, 0 to 2. What's the function? X cube minus 3x square plus 2x into cos of n pi x with respect to x. Now from the UV rule or Bernoulli's rule, which one is a U function? Polynomial is U function. The cosine function is V, because after the third derivative, x cube minus 3x square plus 2x is 0, but cosine function is not 0 up to the nth derivative. From UV rule, what's the first term? Your first function, x cube minus 3x square plus 2x into integration of cos. What is integration of cos? Sine of n pi x divided by quotient of x. What's quotient of x is n pi. Minus, what is the differentiation of x cube minus 3x square plus 2x is 3x square. Okay. Minus derivative of x square is 2x, 3 2s are 6, 6x plus derivative of x with respect to x, we get 2, into again I integrate, what is integration of sine is minus cos of n pi x divided by, again n pi, we get n pi whole square plus the derivative of 3x square is 6x minus 6. Into again I to integrate, what is integration of cos is sine of n pi x, we get n cube pi cube. Okay, and then minus the derivative of 6x with respect to x is 6 minus 0. Again I to integrate, again I to integrate, integration of sine is minus, already have minus, minus into minus plus. Plus integration of sine is minus, minus of cos, we get plus. Already have minus n pi x divided by n pi, already cube, n to the power of 4, pi to the power of 4. Then entire thing, what's the limit? Limit is 0 to 2. Yes. In the next step, I told number of times, whenever I to find out the value of upper and lower limit, suppose product of any one of the function is sine or cos, first try to verify is what happened, the corresponding limit. Now what's the upper limit is 2. Here having product of one of the function is sine, now first try to put n, x is equal to 2. What we get? Sine of 2n pi. What is sine of 2n pi? Is 0. What's our lower limit? Is 0. Sine 0 is 0. Now for both upper and lower limit, this sine function must be 0. What we are going to write, you are already familiar with that. No need to apply the limit. I am going to write this entire, the term must be 0, product must be 0. Don't worry about this. Product of two function, one of the function is 0, corresponding both the limits, what happened, entire term is 0. Similarly, once you move to this side, what is, they are having cos, what is upper limit, cos, 2 cos of 2n pi. What is cos of 2 pi n pi? Minus 1 to the power of 2n, that is a 1 value. And also cos 0 is 1. Similarly, here we have sine n pi x, just now verified that this is also 0 for upper and lower limit, whatever the entire term must be 0. Not necessary to verify that. The next step is, now minus into minus plus, what's a constant? 1 by n square pi square is constant. Keep it outside while applying the limit. Once you keep that outside, what we get actually, upper limit is what? 2. 3 into 4. 2 square is 4. 3 4s are 12. Minus 3 2s are 12. Minus 12 minus 12 is cancelled. What's remaining here? Observe carefully, is one of the very, very important for this step. Now here, once you apply the limit, what happened? 3 2 square. 2 square is 4. 4s are 12, 6 2s are 12 is cancelled, what's the remaining is 2. 2, cos of 2n pi, what is cos of 2n pi is 1, minus lower limit, what is my lower limit is 0. X is 0, x is 0, only remaining 2, cos 0 is 1. Okay. And next, my minus 6 by n to the power of 4, pi to the power of 4 is constant. Keep it outside, cos 2n pi is 1, cos 0 is 1. Now observe carefully, these two, this is also cancelled, this also cancelled. What we get finally, this is actually 0, this is not bn, this is an. Yeah, I return a formula for an, but while writing the constant is wrongly, I written bn, this is an. What is an formula? 0 to 2 f of x cos of n pi x with respect to x. This is an. Now what we get actually an 0. Next I want to find out bn. What is my bn value? Bn is nothing but, yeah, bn equals 0 to 2 x cube minus 3x square plus 2x into, instead of cos, what we have, sine. Don't confuse, this is actually an, sine of n pi x with respect to x. I told an, but while writing, written bn. Now, where to go for which rule? UV rule or Bernoulli's rule. This is nothing but our u function, this is nothing but our v function. From the UV rule or Bernoulli's rule, now what we get actually, the first function, x cube minus 3x square plus 2x into integration of sine. What is integration of sine? Minus cos of n pi x by the quotient of x is n pi. Then minus first term plus second term is minus derivative of the first term. What we get? 3x square minus 6x plus 2 into, again I integrate, integration of causes, I have to keep the minus sign as itself, minus sine n pi x divided by n pi whole square, n pi whole square or n square pi square, plus now where to go for whatever the next derivative of 3x square minus 6x plus 2, what we get? 6x minus 6 into, again I integrate, what's the integration of sine? Minus, already have minus, we get minus into minus plus, cos of n pi x by n pi whole cube minus derivative of 6x minus 6 is 6 because constant is 0. And next, what is integration of causes? Sine of n pi x divided by n pi to the power of 4. Now one point we you know that that's why I'm not explaining here. Once we get a constant, we are going to stop because what is the next higher derivative value, sir? Zero. That's why now not necessary to go for further term because what is the next derivative of the constant must be zero. What's the limit? 0 to 2. Okay. Now in the next step, carefully apply the limit. While applying the limit, just to explain. While finding the value of an, whenever having sine of n pi x, that value definitely 0 for sine of 2n pi and also sine 0. What are the product of one of the function having sine? You already know that where in an this is must be 0 and also this is also must be 0. Not necessary to verify, just now verified in while finding a value of an. Therefore, not necessary to do it once again. Now, only at retained cos because cos 2n pi is 1, cos 0 is 1. Now, while applying the limit, keep the constant minus 1 by n pi is a constant. Okay. Apply the upper limit. What is my upper limit? Is 2. 2 cube. What is 2? Then, if you want to apply 2 cube, okay, fine. Minus 3 into 4, suppose you are confused, plus 2 into 2. Now, observe carefully. 2 cube. What is 2 cube? 8. 8 plus 4 is 12. Minus 12. What happened? This is value must be. Suppose you simplify that, we get 0. Yeah. Into, just try to put 2. Now what we get? Cos of 2n pi. What is cos of 2n pi? Is 1. You already know that. Minus 0. X is 0. Therefore, 0 but cos 0 is 1. Okay. Now, move to this term. Here I have to keep 1 by n cube pi cube as a constant and then apply the upper limit. What is upper limit? 2. 6 2s are 12. 12 minus 6 2s are 12 minus 6 into cos 2n pi is 1. Minus lower limit is 0. X is 0. What we get? Minus 6 into cos 0 is 1. Yeah. Now, what's the remaining here? Actually, this is entire, this term, this also must be 0. 0 into 1 is 0. Therefore, only is remaining this. Now, here observe, 12 minus 6 is 6, minus into minus plus, what we got? 6. 12 minus 6 is 6, minus into minus plus 6, 6 plus 6 is 12, by n cube pi cube for bn. I told very clearly in my previous class, whenever we get an or bn, verify what happened. This is true for n is equal to 1, 2, 3. How to verify? Pick the denominator n for n value. What's the value having n? You don't worry about the numerator. You worried about the denominator. Then whenever the n value 0, then denominator 0, what happened? 1 by 0 is infinity. We are not expecting infinity value for n is equal to 1 to infinity. We are expecting finite value. How can you know that whether is true for n is equal to 1, 2, 3? Once we get the value of bn or an, pick the denominator n quantity. What is my n? N cube value. Now, n cube is 0. I have to equate that n cube to 0. Once you equate to 0, now simplify that, what we get, n is equal to 0. For n is equal to 0, then only bn is infinity, but our summation is ranging from 1 to infinity. Now, confidently say that this is true for n is equal to 1, 2, 3. Now, because n is 0, in which case 0, but 0 is not included in the summation. Therefore, now I have to write this is true for n is equal to 1, 2, 3. That's a very, very important. Once we get the value of n, bn, I have to verify is true for all values of n. Once we get the values of a0, an, and bn, observe a0 is 0, an is 0, only we get bn. Try to substitute, try to construct the Fourier series. Therefore, now f of x equals a0 by 2 is 0, an is 0, only the summation. While writing bn, at keep the constant outside the summation for our convenient. 12 by pi cube is outside. Then summation in ranging from 1 to infinity, 1 by n cube into sine of n pi sine of what actually? Now where to we get which value here? Bn value. Now where to observe carefully here, the thing is sine of n pi x. Sine of n pi x, because Bn also 0, this is nothing but sine of n pi x. Now sine of n pi x we have here, observe carefully, this is nothing but 4, is the, you have to write sine of, because in Bn having sine of n is the required, what actually, Fourier series for the given function over the interval 0 comma 2. I think it's clear, except Bn, An and what about A0 is 0. Next, I want to deduce the result. I want to find out the value of the deduction part. Hence, find the value, sum of the values are. What's the series they given in the problem? For our reference, I'm going to write, I want to find out the value of the series they asking 1 by the 1 by 1 cube minus 1 by 3 cube plus 1 by 5 cube minus 1 by 7 cube etc. plus. This is a series they expecting. They are not given right hand side. They are asking the question is, hence deduce the sum of the value of 1 by 1 cube minus 1 by 3 cube plus 1 by 5 cube minus 1 by 7 cube. Now observe this carefully. You have to observe here having 1 by, see, put n is equal to 1, we get 1 by 1 cube. Put n is equal to 2, we get 1 by 2 cube. And put n is equal to 3, 1 by 3 cube. But observe carefully here having only odd value, n is equal to 1, n is equal to 3, n is equal to 5, n is equal to 7. We don't have any even values. I don't want all 1, 2, 3. I required n is 1, 3, 5, 7 like that. Now here, but I want to retain 1 by n cube. But here I don't want this value, sine n pi value. I don't want sine n pi value. But the thing is, this is okay, 12 by pi cube, we are going to take a cross multiplication, the secondary. But the thing is, here, I want to deduce this 1 by 1 cube minus 1 by 3 cube. Only I required odd values. Therefore, what's the value of x in the range 0 to 2? Observe carefully, it's one of important thing. I'm going to choose x is equal to half. Why I'm choosing x is equal to half? We already discussed in my this third class of Fourier series. Once you put, you have n pi x, put x is equal to half, what we get? Sine of n pi by 2. Sine of n pi by 2 is plus or minus 1 if n is odd. Right? Only odd is plus or minus 1, 0 if n is even. Okay, fine. I don't want even value, only I required odd. In the odd, I want plus and minus sign. Therefore, which one is suitable, which value is suitable for to deduce for this part? For x is equal to half. Here I told in my previous video, we don't have any particular method to deduce, but you compare the required result, what you get Fourier series expansion, you take suitable value. Why I choose half? Half also in the range 0 to 2. Okay, fine. 0 to 2 having a half, therefore that's in the range, in the belongs to the interval 0 comma 2. The thing is, now why I choose n pi by 2? Because I required only odd value. Yeah, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 1 if n is odd. 0 if n is even, therefore it's suitable. Therefore, what we are going to do here, put x is equal to 0. In the above expression, we get I to put simultaneously in the function also f of half equals 12 by pi cube for n ranging from 1 to infinity, 1 by n cube sine of n pi by 2. Okay. Simultaneously, I find out the value of f of x. What is my f of x? They given in the problem. F of x is x into 1 minus x into 2 minus x. F of half. What is f of half? Half into half minus 1. 1 minus half, not half minus 1. I have to put x is equal to half. Yeah, 1 minus half and then 2 minus half. You simplify that. Half, 1 minus half, what we get actually? Half. 2 minus 1 by half is 3 by 2. 4 minus 1 is 3 by 2. Now what we get? 3 by 8 is the answer. Now I have to substitute the value here. 3 by 8 equals 12 by pi cube. You expand this series. Why expansion of this? Once you put n is equal to n pi by 2, only I have to better to take odd values. Once you put 1 to infinity means involving both negative, odd and even value. I am mentioning first two values of odd. What is the first two values? 1, 3, 5, like that means only you are consider odd values. Why? Because sine of n pi by 2 0 for even. While whenever writing this summation for sine of n pi by 2, only I have to choose odd 1, 3, 5, etc. up to infinity. What's the first value? 1 by 1 cube. Put n is equal to 1, what we get? Sine pi by 2. What is sine pi by 2? It's 1. Minus 1 by 3 cube. What is sine of 3 pi by 2? Sine of 3 pi by 2 is minus 1. Yeah, we get plus into minus 1. Similarly, 1 by 5, sine of 5 pi by 2 is 1. Sine of 7 pi by 2 is what actually? Minus 1, etc. Now you simplify that. You take a cross multiplication of this. What we get. Now take pi cube. Yeah, this is a cross multiplication for this. Yeah, pi cube. 3, now before going to take a cross multiplication, 3 ones are, 3 fours are, 8 fours are 32. Okay. 32. Yeah, 3 ones are, 3 fours are, now I have to 8 fours are 32 pi cube. Is nothing but 1 by 1 cube minus 1 by 3 cube plus 1 by 5 cube minus 1 by 7 cube, etc. Now what they are very clever. They are not given right and left the value. Therefore, sum of the values of 1 by 1 cube minus 1 by 3 cube plus 1 by 5 cube minus 1 by 7 cube plus etc. is nothing but what actually? Pi cube divided by 32 is the answer. I think it's clear how we get these values. Now I explained very clearly. Again I'll go back here. The given interval is in the form of 0 to 2. Okay. Therefore, now we are this given problem is referred to the first case. Whenever it's referred to the first case based on my class, we don't have any choice to go for even or odd. Directly I have to construct, before construct we have to find out the value. 0 to 2 is nothing but 0 to 2. We are equal to the upper limit, we get L is 1. Based on that I have to calculate A naught and A n and B n. Once we get B n, we substitute. That is our required Fourier series for the given function over the given interval 0 comma 2. But I have to compare this to this. Now what I'm going to choose, I'm required only odd value for n and simultaneously alternative series plus minus is called alternative series. Now I have to choose the value of x is pi by 2. Once you choose x is pi by 2, sine n pi by 2 plus or minus 1 if n is odd, 0 if n is even. Now automatically we get what they given sum of the series 1 by 1 cube minus 1 by 3 cube plus 1 by 5 cube, etc. What we get after the simplification? Simultaneously, I have to find out f of half from the given function. Half into 1 minus half, 2 minus half, simplify that. What we get actually? 3 by 8, simplify, we get pi cube by 32. Now it's clear for this. Now I move to the next problem. Yeah, second problem. This is also one of the important problem. Second problem is find the Fourier series. Instead of Fourier series, simply I'm going to write f dot s. Is not standard notation. You please expand Fourier series expansion for f of x equals mod x in the interval minus pi less than x less than pi, and hence deduce that summation in ranging from 1 to infinity 1 by 2 n minus 1 whole square must be equal to pi square by 8. This is one of important problem. Okay, now I have to find out the solution. What is my given function? The given function is what actually given? F of x is mod x. And also, they given what's the interval? Minus pi to pi. It's referred to which case? Second case. What is my second case interval? Minus L to L. Whenever the interval is in the form of second case, now we have a chance to go for even or odd definition. Now once you take even or odd definition, first try to verify what happened the given function. Here, f of minus x equals modulus of minus x. What is modulus of minus x? Is mod x. We get f of x, okay? We get f of x. After once you replace minus x, we get the same function. Therefore, f of x is an even, f of x is an even function. F of x is an even function over what's the interval? Minus pi to plus pi. And which value 0? Bn is 0. You already know that. Therefore, and which value 0? Bn 0. The corresponding Fourier series for f of x over the interval, what's the interval? Minus pi comma plus pi is f of x equals, better I to write in different form, f of x is equal to a naught by 2 plus summation n ranging from 1 to infinity a n cos of, yeah, you are writing that first, you have to know the value of L. Now here the given interval is minus pi to pi, the given interval is minus L to L. Compare that upper limit on both sides, we get L is pi. L is pi, therefore what is my n pi x by L? Is n pi x by pi is cancelled, we get nx. Cos of nx, where what are the formulas for a naught and an is an even function, 2 by pi, 0 to pi, f of x dx. And also I have to write the formula for an is 2 by pi, 0 to pi, f of x cos nx with respect to x. Okay, fine. In the next step, as usual, up to this step, you have to take care. Suppose you are very confident with how to evaluate the integral, the rest of the thing is very, very easy. The next I want to find out a naught value. A naught equals 2 by pi, 0 to pi. Now, while taking a function, what is the function have? F of x is equal to mod x. How to define mod x? Mod x is minus x bar x less than or equal to 0. Mod x is x bar x greater than or equal to 0. Now here, what is my limit is 0 to pi. What's the meaning of the integration 0 to pi? X greater than 0, x less than pi. This is a meaning for the limit 0 to pi. What's the 0 to pi? The meaning is x greater than 0, less than pi. X greater than equal to 0. What is my function? X. Function is x with respect to x. Integrate it. That is a very, very important. You can't integrate mod x. Mod x is very far less than 0. Less than 0 means minus pi to 0. Greater than equal to 0 means 0 to pi. What's the function is x. What is integration of x is x square by 2. What's the limit? 0 to pi. 2, 2 cancel. 1 by pi into apply the upper limit. What is my upper limit? Now while applying the upper limit, now we have to be a little bit careful for applying the upper limit here. Now pi square minus 0. Yeah, pi square minus 0 is pi square is cancelled with pi. What's the remaining is pi. Pi is the value for a naught. Next, try to find out an. What is my an? Yeah, an is nothing but 2 by pi, 0 to pi, x cos nx. I go for which rule? UV rule or quotient rule. You are already familiar with that. X is my u function. Y after the first derivative, x is 0. In the next step, 2 by pi, first function into the integration of the second function, sine nx by n minus, what is differentiation of x with respect to x is 1. Again, I have to integrate. What is integration of sine nx? Minus cos nx by n into n is n square. What about the next or higher term is 0? Why? Because derivative of constant is 0. Further higher terms are 0. I have to stop. I have to apply the limit 0 to pi. Okay. While applying the limit, I told very clearly, whenever having sine or cos, first you verify the corresponding limit. We have a sine. What is sine of n pi? Is 0. What is sine 0 value? 0. We have a cos in the second term. Cos n pi. What is cos n pi? Is minus 1 to the power of n. Cos 0 is 1. Now based on that, apply carefully upper and lower limit. Observe product of one of the function is sine. Sine n pi and sine 0 is 0. No need I to apply the limit. Just try to write this value must be 0. Now we get 2 by pi. Yeah, 2 by pi of, yeah, observe carefully, minus into minus plus. What's a constant? 1 by n square is a constant. Apply the upper limit. What's upper limit? Minus 1 to the power of n. Because why I have written minus 1 to the power of n? Cos n pi. What is cos n pi? Is minus 1 to the power of n. Cos 0 is 1. Now this is nothing but 2 pi n square of minus 1 to the power of n minus 1. Once we get an, I told very clearly, verify whether it's true for n is equal to 1, 2, 3. How to verify? Pick the denominator n quantity. What is my n quantity here? N square. N square is 0, in which case n is 0. That implies n is 0, but our summation in an is n ranging from 1 to infinity for summation for an. Therefore, now I have to write confidently this is true for n is equal to 1, 2, etc. Now, before moving to the next step, I want to explain one the thing is very, very important. Whenever having inside the flower bracket, you must and should have to know that minus 1 to the power of n minus 1. One of the term is minus 1 to the power of n. One of the term is maybe plus 1 or minus 1. In that case, even cases are 0, maybe odd cases are 0. For example, I consider minus 1 to the power of n minus 1. Put n is equal to 1. Put n is equal to 1, what happened? Minus 1 minus 1. What we get actually? Here n is equal, this is we get n is equal to 1 minus 2 for n is equal to 1. This is put n is equal to 2 minus 1 whole square. What we get? Minus 1 whole square is 1 minus 1 is 0 for n is equal to 2. Similar put n is equal to 3 minus 1 whole cube is minus minus we get minus 2 for n is equal to 3. This shows that in odd cases commonly we get minus 2, in even cases what we get 0. Therefore, combining these two, now I'm going to write minus 1 to the power of n minus 1 can also be written as, this implies minus 1 to the power of n minus 1 can also be written as minus 2 if n is odd, 0 if n is even. Yeah, this must be, I have to verify whenever inside the flower bracket, one of the term is minus 1 to the power of n and another term is what actually, 1. Similarly, minus 1 to the power of n plus 1. There also, even cases are 2, odd cases are 0. Now keep in mind overall, inside the flower bracket, one of the term is minus 1 to the power of n, one of the term is 1. You verify that either even cases we get common non-zero value, odd cases are 0, maybe ulta. Odd cases maybe you get a non-zero value, even cases are 0. It depends upon what type of expression have inside the flower bracket. Therefore, this an can also be written as, is commonly minus 4, minus 2, you already have 2, 2 into 2 is 4, minus 4 by pi n square if n is odd, okay? 0, this value itself is 0, product must be 0, 0 if n is even, yeah. While construction of Fourier series, we have to take care f of x is equal to what is my a naught? Pi a naught by 2 is pi by 2. While writing an, what's a common? Now we have to take only odd value, not necessary take even. Now what's a common here? Minus 4 by pi is a common value. It's a constant value. I'll keep it outside. 1 to, not necessary to take 1 to infinity. I have to take only odd value. Whenever I have to take only odd value, at least I have to mention first two odd values. Whenever we are considering the summation only even values, there I have to write it at least first two even values, 2 comma 4 like that, understood, only we consider odd values, similarly even values. Now what we get, 1 by n square cos of nx. This is the, what actually is the required Fourier series for the given function. Okay. But I want to deduce something in this problem. I want to deduce here sigma n ranging from 1 to infinity, 1 by 2n minus 1 whole square divided by pi square. I'm going to write once again for here the right hand side corner. I want to deduce sigma n ranging from 1 to infinity, 1 by 2n minus 1 whole square must be equal to what? Pi square by 8. I want to deduce this. Okay. Now, we have to carefully observe here. Now, anyway, here having 1 by n square. Yeah. Instead of n square, 2n minus 1 whole square, don't worry about that. But instead of cos nx, here what you have? 1 you have. Instead of cos nx, what you have? 1. Now I'm trying to convert this cos nx must be equal to 1. Observe carefully, don't worry about that 2n minus 1 square for 1 to infinity, but you have n square, but we don't have cos. We don't have any cosine function. I try to convert this cosine function must be equal to 1. In the range, what's the range? Minus, what's the function they given? Function is f of x is equal to mod x in the range minus pi to pi. Now what's the value we are going to choose? X is equal to 0. 0 definitely in the range minus pi to pi. Why I have to choose x is 0? Once you put x is 0, what is cos 0 is 1. Therefore, put x is equal to 0 in the epo expression. In the above expression, what we get actually, f of 0 must be equal to pi by 2 minus 4 by pi for n ranging from 1 to infinity, 1 to infinity 1 by n square. 1 by n square. In the next step, now what is f of 0? Mod x, you already know that mod x is how to define minus x power x less than or equal to 0, x power x greater than or equal to 0. In both the case, what happened? F of 0 must be 0. This value must be 0. What I'm going to do here, I'm taking this negative term in the left hand side. What we get? 4 by pi summation n ranging from 1 to infinity, not 1 to infinity, sorry, 1 comma 3, because only odd values 1 comma 3, 1 by n square must be equal to pi by 2. Yeah, observe carefully, 1 comma 3, just try to put x is 0. Now we have to take cross multiplication. We get, what we get actually, summation 1 comma 3 means only we are considered odd value. This implies summation n ranging from 1 comma 3 means only the odd value 1 by n square must be equal to pi square by 8. But here, instead of this, what we have 1 by 2n minus 1 whole square, but n ranging from 1 to infinity. Observe, instead of this can also be written as 1 by 2n minus 1 whole square for n ranging from 1 to infinity. It's nothing but pi square by 8. Observe carefully, you expand this series. What's the first term? N is equal to 1. N is equal to 1, 2 minus 1. What is 2 minus 1? 1 square. Put n is equal to 2, next value, 4 minus 1, what we get? 1 by 3 square. Next, put n is equal to 3, 6 minus 1, 5 square. Right, clear? Suppose you expand this, what we get? Suppose expand this, what we get actually? 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 3 square, etc. Observe carefully, these two series are must be equal. Therefore, for n ranging from odd values 1 by n square can also be written as 1 to infinity. Instead of n, what we are going to replace? 2n minus 1 whole square. 2 instead of n, what we are going to take? 2n minus 1. These two series are must be equal, right? Therefore, this is what they are expecting in the problem. Are you clear? Now, instead of that, what I did? N ranging from 1 to infinity. Instead of n, what we are going to, this is a way to change odd value, only odd values of n in terms of 1 to infinity. We are considered both odd and even values. Already expand and showing that both are must be same. This is a way I to prove the required result for f of x is equal to mod x. This is one of the different problem. Now try to understand that. You go through very carefully for each and every step. You write it in your notes, then easy to understand. Now, thank you very much for listening what I explained this class. Now, we come and meet in next class with some more problem. Bye. See you and take care.